Oh yeah, now I can hear you.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, now I can.
My first Insta live chat.
Yeah. Welcome. You make your debut here.
Yeah, but I don't do all this.
I know.
I
I
don't
know.
have, you know? My second, no, you just do it. It's okay. It's for CS. Okay.
Ranveer is saying, Sakshi, what's up?
Okay, hi.
Ranveer is saying. Yeah. But I like the choice of color, by the way, because that's the first thing we need to talk about. Like, nice color. You're looking lovely. I love it.
No, I have a
And
lot of wardrobe, so. And it's summertime, it's hot in Ranchi, it's hot today, it's humid.
yeah. And today it's possibly going to rain because the weather's also a little gloomy. So yeah, let's
Prison,
hope for.
precisely 5 minutes, and it's all gone now.
Wow, nice. Ranveer Singh, very impressed. He's like, first ever Wah Dhamaka debut. Wo to hai. That's cool. We all know that. Comes with the trade. But Sakshi, thank you so much. Really, it's been really sweet of you to come on and speak to us. You know, all your fans, everyone who've been waiting to, you know, see you. It's really
Mahi
sweet.
fans, not mine. All Mahi's fans follow me, so that Instagram is like good followers. Thanks to Mahi's
Yeah,
fans.
yeah. All love. It's all genuine affection and love. But I want to ask you, Sakshi, how has lockdown been? Has there been a sense of restlessness amongst all of you? Of course, with Ziva and MS, has there been a bit of restlessness about?
So to be honest, we've always lived like this in Ranchi. Maximum, Mahi used to go to the stadium to practice, which is like 10 minutes drive home, and I used to go to the gym. Otherwise, we all stayed at home. We didn't do anything. It was like we were homebound. And maximum, yeah, obviously, Ziva used to go to school. That's it. And Mahi's friends used to come, they used to come home. That's it. Otherwise, we are fine. Ziva has kept us occupied. The dogs have kept us occupied. So yeah, it's been busy.
Yeah, I know, and all the few little glimpses in the lives that you've given, of course, has given a lot of us a lot of happiness and positivity. I think that's the most important thing in a lockdown. But has anything different happened? Have you or MS done something new, tried a new activity, or done something, explored anything new in this time at all?
No, not really, but Mahi has sort of assembled about 7 bikes all by himself. He's restored them actually. Old bikes. He opened them up and he bought like parts. So he assembled it. I'm like, wow, like 9 bikes all alone.
Wow.
He's
How
sitting
did
and
he have a manual? How did he go?
I don't know,
Just
like he reads up about it and he does it.
that is amazing. I think that's incredible.
He was doing he was assembling a bike and he like fully assembled it. I don't know what that part called. He forgot to put that part, so the bike was not starting. So he had to open the next day. He's like, Saksh, I assembled the whole thing, and imagine I forgot to put one thing which is lying right in front of me. So the next day he had to open up the bike, like completely rip off the bike, and then just to put that part, he had to do it all over again.
Wow, so he can also go wrong when it comes to bikes. Yeah, it's good to know. It's good to know that he's also not perfect.
No, he's not perfect at all.
No, but you've also been doing a lot of I mean, it's interesting. I mean, obviously, because from whatever interactions we've had, actually, I know how you're always cheerful, you're always bubbly, smiling. But the side to you that I didn't know, of course, was, you know, poetry and writing, and that was nice. How did that come about, and what made you do all of that? It's interesting.
I can go wrong also. It was like there's so much time and I was pretty bored, so I'm like, okay, let me write. People are like discovering themselves, so I
Yeah.
was writing. But I can go wrong with my poetry. Like I'm not like perfect, so
Yeah.
yeah.
No, but it's good to explore. It's always a nice place to explore and start.
That's true.
Yeah. But I definitely, of course, the other thing that we really have to talk about, we really wanted to, of course, you know, have a chat about, was the fact that in July you're going to complete 10 years of marriage
Yes.
with Mahi. That is incredible to be married for 10 years is incredible. How's that? How's it been, Sakshi? How's the journey been for you?
I would say it's been good. It's been good. Yes. Like, honestly speaking, whatever, like, I've seen the world through Mahi, to be honest. Yeah. I was in college and I graduated from college and within a month I got married to him. So whatever I've seen it through him. And before college, I was in a boarding school. So, you know, like how protected you are in a boarding school. And even college was like boarding college. Again, you were protected. So yeah, whatever the world, whatever I've learned it with him, through him.
Wow. If you had to pick a particular moment over the last 10 years that you cherish the most, what would it be, Sakshi?
When he got honored, like obviously Padma Bhushan.
Yes.
And then he got like his honorary rank as Lieutenant Colonel.
Yes, yes.
And then the World Cup 2011.
Wow. Yeah. Those are special memories for sure. Is it? But
actually, a lot of memories with him. But like, you know, these are the top three.
Yeah, of course, understandably so. But you know, you mentioned, of course, all these moments, and I want to ask you, how is it like? I mean, we of course see him on the field. We know just like 10% of what the person he is, and you are of course someone who's the closest to him. He's so calm, and there's nothing about it. You don't know what's happening between these 2 years.
He's not calm.
Yeah, we don't want to get into a certain bit of that. But yeah, I want to know how he's like at home. Can you tell when something upsets him? Can you tell when his mood changes?
I'm the only one who can upset him. I have that thing in me. I can, you know, he's like calm about everything. So, yeah. You know, I'm the only one who can like provoke him or upset him because I'm the closest to him, obviously.
Yeah.
So yeah, kahin aur ka gussa comes out on me, I'm fine with it because you know, I'm the closest again.
Yeah.
Where else will he take out?
Yeah, no bowlers should talk to you for tips, huh? No bowlers should talk to you for tips on how to upset Mahi.
It's very easy. For me, yeah.
Wow, that's nice. So, has he managed to, you know, upset you or kind of pull a bit of your trigger as well? Or is it just you who kind of cracked it?
When you're married for 10 years, you know each other in and out. And you argue, you fight, then you make up. It's all part of being married.
Yeah.
So it's fun also to fight with him at times. Because nobody picks a fight with him. Like, I'm the only one. Everybody does a big fight up to him.
There's some pictures I want to show, Sakshi. These are cute ones, which we have kind of compiled, and we really want you to have a look at it. And this one, I think, is what I should start off with. I think this is really cute. This is like a mashup of all these cute little moments. Can you see them?
Yes. Yeah. I have a memory with each, actually. That you have the Dhanolti picture? That was like before marriage.
Yeah, we just managed to get a few of those. Just wanted you to kind of talk through some of those moments. He's tying your shoelace in one. He's perpetually doing like amazing tasks, like tying your shoelace there, something there. And of course, so the finishes are there.
We were going out for dinner. We were in Dubai, I think. Yeah. We were going out for dinner. He knew that he'd do it fast. We were waiting for the lift and the lift had come. So he's like, let me do it fast. I'm like, okay. He knew he'll do it quicker than me. So I'm like, okay.
Like, cute.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are some nice moments. I just wanted to get that picture across and, you know, so you can relive some of those memories. But you do, of course, talk about how he's at home. Do you guys talk cricket though, Sakshi? Is that a conversation?
Not at all.
Do you think that's really important to keep that part aspect outside the house?
That's his profession. See, today, like, suppose, like, you know, your husband goes to office and you start asking them, oh, what did you do? What did your boss say? What did your, like, you can't. What did you talk about all that?
Yeah.
They're professionals. So, professional. You cannot talk about his baby, his love.
You know, we were having this conversation also a little bit earlier, Sakshi, where, you know, you told me how you know, when we were discussing about this and I said, you know, we should talk about the sacrifices and stuff. And you say, no, I can't call it sacrifices. Sacrifice is something that army guys do. I thought it was very interesting. How difficult or easy has it been for you to know that, you know, this is important for him. This is what I need to talk to him about. I should not talk to him about this. Should not ask him about this. How have you been able to negotiate that?
No, it's been easy. He's a, like, first of all, we don't discuss cricket, okay?
Yeah.
And actually, everything has been easy. Yeah,
it's not just know it.
Yeah, like, even like when Ziva happened, like, Ziva was like a pre-planned baby. So I knew she's going to happen, like, during the World Cup and everything. And it didn't make sense for him to come back to see her, take two flights, that too, you know, just before the World Cup started. Mm-hmm. So I'm like, okay. And like everybody in the hospital, like, oh, your husband's not coming. I'm like, it's fine. It doesn't matter. Cricket is priority and he's my priority. So whatever his priority is my priority. So yeah, that was one. And, you know, people still tell me, oh, you know, he was not there. How you have to sacrifice so much. I'm like, no, nothing. It's all out of love. When you're in love, you can't, like, you cannot call it sacrifice. Just do it because you love that person.
Yeah, because he would probably do the same thing if it was you and you would do that. It's just natural.
Yeah, it's just natural, yeah.
You know, there's something else I want to ask you about, of course, is that, you know, as someone who is obviously a lot in the public scanner, both of you are, you know, in many ways, there's obviously so many of these rumors that keep floating about or controversies that keep coming up. How do you tackle that? You have to tell me which is the funniest or the weirdest that you have heard about both of you, and how do you tackle it?
So, you know, like when we got married, like, you know, you tend to put on weight, and you know, I started eating what Mahi, sweet butter chicken, masala dosa. So, you know, I landed up eating and I landed up gaining, you know, few kgs, and then suddenly, you know, like obviously I had put on weight, and, you know, it's like, oh, she's pregnant. So every year I was pregnant, basically. Used to put on weight and has to lose weight, whatever. But then when I got pregnant, nobody got to know. You know, this was like, these are, and plus, there's one more rumor, like when Mahi and I are like childhood friends, there's like 7 years gap between us. We cannot be childhood friends. My first time I stepped into Ranchi, first time was after marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Like in 2010, like 7th of July on his birthday. Came to Ranchi. And but people say we are childhood friends, we studied in the same school, our parents are friends, blah blah blah. I'm like, theek hai, you know, like, still, like, big media houses say that, and I'm like, what is this rubbish?
But how does he react to rumors, Sakshi? Is there like a mental block saying, okay, or you've decided, suba utne hi, something is going to be said in the paper, something's going to be tweeted, something is come, meme is going to happen. Are we prepared? Is he also like that?
See, the thing is, see, when you have that social media exposure, you have to be mentally prepared to be trolled or to be praised or whatever. There's like, so everybody has their opinions, everybody has their views. You know, people like you, people hate you. You cannot do anything about it, which is fine. So when you're on a, like, Instagram or Twitter, whatever you're writing your own opinion. So if people troll you, it's fine. Like, I mean, to be honest. And Mahi and I, we really don't really follow up on news or Twitter. Even that day when that hashtag was 2 days ago, when that hashtag was trending, one of my friends, she messaged me, like, she's like, what is this going on? Like, really close friend, okay? She also knows how don't respond, we don't react. So she's like, it's been trending since afternoon. I'm like, what bullshit? Then I don't know, some kida happened, so I and then I deleted
it. We love that about you.
And started saying, aray, this hashtag, don't, like, delete it, the hashtag is bad. I said, okay. Then I deleted it, but the job was done, the message was put out.
Yeah, I think then everyone started saying, no, never retires, no, never retires. But yeah, it's, I think,
upset, like, people, because, you know, every time something happens, like, you know, Mahi, any movement of his, I start getting calls because everybody has my number. So, you know, instead of answering each and every one of them, I just put it up on Twitter. It's easier. Otherwise, I get bombarded with messages and calls.
Yeah. Yeah, no, understandable so. Understandably
Yeah.
so, and it's I mean the way you guys handle it of course is
I write so much about him, and he's like poor thing. He's like just like low profile. He's had zero, like during this lockdown, he's had zero presence on social media, not spoken to anybody. I don't know, like still people keep writing. It's funny. Like I don't know what it is.
Yeah.
But
no, understandable. So I think it's a way of someone trying to get your attention. I think
yeah.
That's why they try to do that.
Yeah, I get it.
But yeah, understandably so. But moving on, Sakshi, I wanted to ask about Ziva, of course. Amazing bundle of joy. I used to keep bumping into her at breakfast, and obviously, superb to interact and talk to. How has motherhood been? How has that journey been for you?
It's been fun, actually. Like, you know, you feel like first couple of months, the baby doesn't move, doesn't talk. You're like, when will she talk? When will she move? And the moment she starts talking, then you're like, why did she start talking? She talks. Mahi has come to a conclusion that, oh, she talks more than you, Sakshi. I'm like, okay, that's fine. It's good, right?
He yeah, said, it's good.
No, but to be honest, both of us, we are having a tough time because she talks a lot. Like, obviously, this is that age also, she's learning and all. But yeah, it's been tough. But it's been fun.
I'm sure. I mean, this is a cute picture. Again, I wanted you to kind of get a little nostalgic. This is when she didn't talk.
When she didn't talk.
This beautiful memories, of course. But who's the strict one, Sakshi? Need to be honest here. Is it you?
Mahi, not me.
Are you serious?
Yeah. She only listens to him. So if I'm telling you something, if I'm telling you, finish your food quickly or just eat vegetables. I'll have to tell her 10 times, including my mother, including Sheila auntie. Okay, we have to tell her like 10 times. Mahi will just tell once and it'll happen like this in a jiffy.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I basically to put like, you know, like to make things, yeah, just tell him, like just tell her to do this now, please. And he'll tell her once and she'll do it.
Yeah. Well, you found a way at least. That's good.
Yeah. Only when he's at home. When he's not at home, it's so difficult.
Yeah. Is it difficult? How is it touring then with Ziva? Because I know CSK, you spent almost the entire campaign 2018. We'll of course come to that in a bit. But how is touring with Ziva? Is it more difficult or easier?
It's easy. There's so many kids.
Yeah.
In the camp is the daddy's army. And like, it's fun. It's like a family affair, you know. To be
yeah. There's another picture I wanted to show you. And this is a very, very cute one. Because I have to ask you this question that everyone will probably continue to ask. This is what you with Mahi and his long hair days.
No. That's a wig. They were during a shoot.
What are you saying?
Yeah.
Seriously.
Yeah.
So he'd already cut his hair by this time.
But luckily, I did not see him with long hair. Because if I had seen him with that orange long hair, I wouldn't have ever even looked at him. You know, there has to be some aesthetics, you know.
I wanted you to say this. I was like, yeah. Like, but everybody had that thing about long-haired Mahi. Thoda, matlab, everyone liked that phase also.
John. So, John had sort of suited him that time. John. But Mahi with long hair, with that orange color on top of that was like...
Which is the worst haircut he's ever had, according to you?
That orange hair, which I saw luckily like after I like got to know him.
Yeah.
And I fell in love with him. After that, I saw his orange hair, so it was fine. I'm like, thank God, I'm only with short hair.
But there's a lot of these talks also. I wanted to ask you, but you were saying when you met him and stuff, I wanted to ask you about your first impressions, of course, because in the movie, obviously, there's a particular way in which they portray your romance. And, you know, the fact that you didn't know him then, can you tell us how it was when you first met? You know, I would like to hear it from you, of course.
You know how it is. It's like a director, they take the liberty to, like, you know, for creativity, whatever, to capture the audience and all that.
Huh.
But, the first time I met him through a common friend. And it was my last day of internship at Taj, obviously, interning. It was my last day. And I met him through my common friend. And he seemed to be a very regular guy and very, like, normal. And for me, that time, I didn't follow cricket much because, see, I was in a boarding school and then I went to college. So, we really did not have time to follow it. Obviously, we knew Sachin Tendulkar, Dravid, Saurav Ganguly.
Yeah.
And we knew all those players. But that time, I did not know. I knew that there's a Pahadi guy. You know, some guy who's a Pahadi. He's got long hair and he's a Hulk. And my mom, you know, she's a fan of him. And she told me, oh, good Pahadi guy in the team and all that. So that's how I knew of him.
Cute.
Really, I met him. I'm like, Mama, he has got short hair. He doesn't have long hair. And he seemed very normal, regular. Yeah. Like, you know, he's a cricket. He didn't have any airs. I don't think so. Any cricketers, they have airs about themselves. They are very humble and they're very good, you know, like,
down to earth. Yeah. That was, I think that was
all down to earth.
Yeah. I guess that's exactly what he was like. Did he also always kind of have that, even back then, did he have that, obviously the love for bikes and all that? You did say that he restored some during the lockdown. That's amazing. But what is it about him and video games? Why does he love it so much?
I think it's like a stress buster for him. Mm-hmm. Yeah, because, you know, Mahi's got a thinking brain, to be honest. He's got a thinking brain. It doesn't rest. So I think when he plays video games, be it Call of Duty, and be it PUBG or whatever, I think it just helps him divert his mind. That's it. And which is a good thing. I mean, I don't really get irritated till it's got to the bedroom. And nowadays, PUBG has encroached my bed. He's talking on, and at times I feel he's talking to me, and then he's on the headphones and he's talking to all the people who are playing.
Yeah.
And then he's sleep talking also about PUBG nowadays.
I love it. I love the fact that that's actually what's like taking charge of the, I mean, it's amazing. Who would have thought, right? I mean, understandably so. He loves video gaming, and that's, even we know how it is.
I feel it's a good thing. Even I love, but I've been playing poker and playing Ludo. Yella Ludo. Because Yella Ludo, you can talk and play. Normal Ludo, you can't talk and play. Yella Ludo's quick.
Yeah. So, but you also, I mean, come on, Sakshi, during the times that you were with CSK, of course, you were great at TT. You used to keep yourself busy there. Yes, yes.
I remember you playing TT. Yes. I remember a lot of people playing TT.
Yeah. We know what we're talking about.
I remember the comment.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. So it's good. I think you guys keep yourself busy that way. It's always nice. But yeah, one thing, of course, definitely what I wanted to obviously ask was video gaming. But that's a nice thing. It's interesting. But one picture also I wanted to show, Sakshi. This is cute. And I mean, you can talk about all of them, of course. Are the loves of your lives. Okay, sorry, it's inverted. But this is all the names of your dogs.
Yeah.
Those collars. Lily and Sam and was there any thinking behind naming the dogs or something like that?
So earlier, Mahi had had like three dogs: Sam, Zara, Zoya. So they passed away some time ago. So when these new dogs came to us, so we thought we'll keep the same names because we missed them, and plus, you know, a dog soul, you they never die. Dog soul, you know, it's always with you. They say. So yeah, we renamed them again, the same name we use. And Lily Gabbar was just very random, you know. We were like, okay, she's white husky, okay, let's call her Lily. And Gabbar was because he's the only male amongst all the female dogs, so yeah, he had to have that name.
Very cute. There's another picture that I wanted to show you, of course, Akshan. This is a very cute one. It went viral, and the love that you got after you put this up was unbelievable. Is this one?
Okay, yeah. Let's not talk about this picture.
No, but then what I want to talk about is CSK and how close you are to that. And it's not just about Mahi and CSK. It's about you and CSK also. And that's a connect that is priceless.
So I think the timing of the picture was not when CSK was not, they were not playing. We won't talk about that. But yeah, so I think with CSK, it's always been a very nice, like, pleasant affair with them, and Mahi's been playing with them since, obviously, before we got married. It's just very nice to be part of that entire family and, you know, travel and watch. And even when these guys, suppose they've had a bad day, the owners and the franchisee people, they come and support the boys and they're like, no, no, it's okay, it's fine. And they take the sport, you know, so there's no hard feelings.
Mm-hmm.
It's a sport, somebody has to lose, somebody has to win. But yeah, for CSK, I think it's obviously they're such a good team and we've always had good memories.
Yeah. I want to obviously particularly ask about 2018, Sakshi, because that was an emotional year. We know that. I mean, there's a picture, of course, I want to show you also at the when CSK won and how you reacted. Dhoni was teary-eyed in that first dinner that he came. How emotional was that year for both of you?
So luckily, I wasn't there for that dinner. I was still in Ranchi that time.
No, you're not so, coming yet, yeah.
If I'm teary-eyed, I would have howled and cried. And, you know, it happens automatically. But luckily, I wasn't there. But yes, after 2 years, when you're coming back and when your team, you're like, you know, CSK is being called old, everybody's so old, everybody are like, you know, everybody has whatever their daddies and they're old and what will this team do and blah, blah, blah. So, you know, after all that, finally they won. And obviously, it was a good feeling after 2 years coming back and winning, starting with a bang, actually.
Have you ever seen Mahi being emotional about cricket prior to that?
Yeah, Mahi's always emotional about cricket. Yeah. It's his love, so he's always emotional. So, you know, for me, it was emotional. It was last, I remember, we won was Champions Trophy when Ziba was in my tummy. So, that was last of Champions Trophy. And then I think when Ziba was a few months old, then the team got banned. And then finally, 2018... was like old enough to see, you know, who have, like, especially see her father and, like, you know, rest of everybody, like, you know, what cricket is, what a sport is, to witness all that winning and side both. For it also, it's a good exposure.
Yeah, it is. It is nice to see her like that. But obviously, which was your first ever experience of watching a cricket match where Mahi was playing Sakshi? Was it CSK? Was that the first time?
No, my first was back in my college days. In Bombay, I had like, you know, so I think Brabourne Stadium, there was a test. So I was there, and his old manager Yudhajit Datta was there that time, and even was there like a couple of people. So, you know, I had only gone to see Mahi, to be honest. Okay. So he was wicket keeping, India was fielding, and you know, I see like we were behind the wicket. So Mahi was right, why has he gone to the other side? You know, because I did not know the sides after every six. On TV, if you see, the bowlers all the time, the bowlers bowling out.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I was a bit confused. So, yeah, people, after that, it was fine. Like, then they told me, explained me, oh, you don't know this. I'm like, listen, it's fine. If I don't know. And I still don't know the field placements and all that. I don't know a lot of things. I don't need to know also. It's fine.
Just a few more questions. I know that you have other stuff you have to get to. So just a few more questions before we wrap up, of course, Sakshi. One thing, of course, is that if a lot of people don't know this. You know, during the time that you guys travel at CSK, Mahi's door is always open.
Yeah.
Everyone's coming in. Everyone says only one thing, that you're the most hospitable. You're most accommodating. You like invite people. You're like, yeah, cool. Come anytime. Anyone can walk in. You'll order food. How is that experience and how has it been for you to kind of adjust to that kind of a way of things?
So, you know, this has been since we got married, actually. Since 2010, Yeah, because I remember the first tour with CSK was South Africa. Again, I think Champions Trophy and obviously Sri Lanka tour. A lot of tours straight after marriage was Sri Lanka. So, Mahi's always kept his door open. He's always told me that, fine, we are married. The door always, it'll always remain. So I said, that's fine. He said, yeah, in your night suit. Just don't be in a night suit. Just be nicely dressed because the door will always remain open. I said, that's fine. When people come and, you know, everybody, I mean, I like to feed people. Yeah. You feel, well, it's been like that since 2010. The door has always been open during the tours, and people come. We sit up till 4 o'clock, 3 o'clock. I time, you know how the time is. At times we eat breakfast and then we sleep.
Yeah.
So yeah, people are in a throughout. So you know they come to talk to Mahi and all that, and when they talk to Mahi, I sort of go away when they talk about cricket. You know, so that they get to talk to him. That's it. Otherwise, most of the so we are just chilling together.
Yuzvendra yeah. Chahal is like dying to say hi to you. He wants to play Ludo with you apparently.
Yalla Ludo.
Like, Bhaji, Ludo mein challenge karta hu isse.
Okay. Challenge.
Okay. Okay. Yeah, and he's saying we miss you, but truly, how much do you and MS miss CSK at this point, Sakshi?
We of course miss CSK. We've always, like, you know, all these days, we are still wondering whether IPL is going to happen or not.
Sure, but
sure. Yeah, so yeah, we do miss CSK, and like my daughter also, she's like, when will it happen? And we're like, oh, let's see.
Yeah, let's hope. Of course, everyone's asking, where's Mahi? Mahi is getting clothes that might get wet. He's just getting them inside. That's what I think. I'm done.
Good one. Yeah. No, you know Mahi, how he is. Like, just for everybody to know, you know, Mahi won't really come on talk on Insta live. And he's had pressure to, you know, post videos on coronavirus and all. But he hasn't, because, you know, if you said something, you jolly well follow it. And nobody's bigger than your PM right now in the country. So, yeah, that's why he's not done all of these promotions and all these, like, not promotions, sorry, wrong word. But, yeah, like, you know, he's not instated anything on social media.
Very sweet. But that was nice. Thanks. I'm sorry. I was just kind of seeing some more messages that were coming, but it's that's cool. I mean, I understand this. It's actually very sweet if you actually say this as well. I'm sure they've all, I mean, they always love you.
That, like, you knowing Mahi, like, I know they're crazy about it. They'll know that he's always kept a low profile on social media. Look at his Instagram, like, how many pictures has he posted? Just look at that.
The cutest one, by the way, was the one that I had taken of both of you sleeping at the airport before boarding that flight.
You don't sleep all night. People are in a room.
I was a late finish and we were leaving the very next day in the morning.
Yeah.
And then we were early afternoon, morning, late morning.
No, early for us because we slept, we didn't sleep all night. No?
Obviously, yeah. Understandable. Thank you. So much for joining. I know if we talk, we'll just keep talking because it's always great catching up with you. Seriously. Yeah. Just one question. Post-lockdown, what are the things that you or MS and Zio, what is it that you want to do? Maybe before we wrap up.
So post, see, if there's cricket, there'll be cricket. But if there's no cricket post-lockdown, then Mahi and I have planned to hit the hills. We'll go to Uttarakhand, go trekking, go like in the snow. Like Mahi loves snow. He loves hills. Mm-hmm. He doesn't like beaches. So we are planning to go to Uttarakhand and like go to like small town, small villages there, stay there. So yeah, that's our plan. Okay. Yeah, that's... But yeah, they're not going to travel by flight. They're going to do all like road trips now because I think it'll be safer. Yeah.
Yeah. And more fun, actually. You'll see the place as you're going. I think that's a nicer experience.
Yeah. That's awesome.
So nice talking to you, Sakshi. I really wish we see each other in person rather than on video calls.
I know. So much to talk about.
Yeah, but thank you so much for doing this. Lots and lots of love to you, MS Diva, of course, goes without saying.
Thank you.
Take care, of course.
Shriram doing? No, she. What's his name? Swami? Murli. How is Murli doing?
He's fine. Perfectly fine. By the way, we just completed 10.
What? Congratulations.
Thank you. This month.
Wish him from my. Hope you're not
traveling. He sends his love as well. So nice chatting with you and really, really see you soon and hope things all pan out well.
Yeah. Fingers crossed. Yeah. See you.
Bye. Thank you so much, guys. I know it was difficult to catch a bit of Mahi. Sakshi was saying all the relatives are there and everyone's busy. So, needed to keep them occupied as well. So too the kids. So thank you so much for being here. It's been awesome, and I hope you enjoyed this short conversation with Sakshi and kind of probably gave you a little more insight into her, the person, and her along with the family. So thank you so much, and of course keep watching this space and of course my page for more. Unwritten Lines is not gonna end here. Of course, that's our journey that's continuing. Of course, so too your love for CSK and Chennai. Thank you so much for watching. Have a lovely weekend, and of course, see you soon.